Okay, another property of wave functions that's useful is the orthogonality of wave functions. So for non-degenerate system, we really haven't defined non-degenerate, but this means systems that are not equal in energy. All right, for non-degenerate systems, two wave functions are orthogonal if you take one of the wave functions and multiply it by another wave function. And again, we're doing the complex conjugate psi. This means that you take the complex conjugate, multiply together, you get a real number. Two wave functions are orthogonal if you take two different wave functions, multiply them together, and integrate over all space if you get zero. That means the wave functions are orthogonal. All right, so what we'll learn, in fact, that these wave functions, for instance, in the p orbitals, let's take an example, the p orbitals. P orbitals, those orbitals are really wave functions. And let's say this is the y-axis and this is the x-axis. Here's a orbital for the py, and here's a picture of the orbital for the, this is the py, this is the px, and these are wave functions. And wave functions are the p orbitals. Okay, we'll learn that a little later on. The point here is that the px and py are orthogonal. These wave functions, px, py, are orthogonal. O-N-A-L, and learn how to spell that. What does that mean? Well, let's go back here. It means that if we multiply the two together and integrate over all space, we'll get zero. All right. These, as you may remember from organic or intro chem, the px and py, they don't overlap in space. What does that mean? Well, that means there's no overlap. So if you integrate this times that, there's no area that there's any overlap. And therefore, when you integrate these over space, multiply these two together and integrate over space, you get zero. So the integral of the wave function corresponding to the px times the wave function corresponding to the py, we really put it a complex conjugate, but it doesn't really matter, integrated over all space, that's equal to zero because they don't overlap in space. So that's what it means for wave functions to be orthogonal. They essentially don't overlap in space, and therefore if you multiply them together and integrate over all space, you'll get zero.